hygiene and nursing were major issues. So, when we are faced with death, does an attitude change? How does the patient cope with the idea of imminent death? What about the wife, husband, child or parent? Is there a way this process can be made easier? Can we help the family through bereavement? The key to all such thought-provoking questions is palliative care. The World Health Organization defines palliative care as an approach that improves the quality of life of patients and their families facing a problem associated with life-threatening illness to the prevention and relief of suffering by means of early. Imagine all these services being provided at home. Ladies and gentlemen, introducing home-based palliative care. The essence of palliative care lies within home-based palliative care team. Formulation of this team demands a multidisciplinary approach where members focus on achieving certain objectives. The core team consists of a doctor who is consultant physician in palliative medicine along with a specialist nurse. Whereas the extended team consists of psychologists, art therapist, music therapist, occupational therapist, etc. These two together constitutes the home-based palliative care team. Community volunteers are the support system of this team and their training courses are open to all. To put into the words of volunteer, we are trained to diagnose suffering and not disease.
The team providing home care will function under the Department of Palliative Medicine along with other services. To know its detailed functioning, we accompany the home care team of Bhakti Vedant Hospital led by Dr. Vinita Sharma. After visiting various organizations like Paracare, Tata Memorial Hospital, Dr. Ernest Borges Memorial Home and Companion Healthcare Foundation, we got significant insights on the same. Few distant centers like Can Support and Palliative India were approached via Skype. Jennifer Moore Valentine gave us valuable inputs regarding working of palliative care and home-based teams in the US through a Skype interview as well. After obtaining this first-hand information, we got to know that the first and most important step in providing these services is registration of the patient. After being registered, the patient is briefed about the concepts of palliative care and plans included in his care by the consultant in palliative medicine. During the first home visit, the entire team visits the patient's home and procures all necessary details about the patient and family. While going for the visit, the team carries basic tools or equipment. Along with this, there is a record book maintained by both the patient's caregivers and by the team.
Most of the teams have the vehicles provided by the department for reaching the patient, and for those not having these facilities, the traveling expenses are reimbursed. The follow-up visits usually depend on the patient's condition and where he stands according to the triage system. Based on the ESAS scores, there are 24/7 emergency helpline numbers available, and the acute centers like Tata Memorial also run a telemedicine center to provide these services. Thus, out-of-house services is a very important aspect. Their liaison with the local general practitioner is a savior. After being referred to a palliative care consultant, home-based palliative care was a turning point in my life. The home care team celebrated my birthday and my volunteer friends entertained me for hours. They switched the treatment from being about the disease to being about me. My days were numbered, but the home care team made them count.
पेशेंट भी ऐसे हैं कि जरूरत हो तभी हॉस्पिटल नहीं ले जा सकते, तो अगर हम रिलेटिव केयर में फोन करते हैं तो वो डॉक्टर खुद आपके पास आ जाते हैं, तो घर पे ये सब फैसिलिटी मिलने से हमको बहुत सुविधा हो गया है। वॉलेंटियर्स हैं, वो आने से मैंने देखा है कि माँ हमेशा बहुत खुश रहती है और हमेशा वो वेट करें कि कब वॉलेंटियर्स आएंगे और इन फ्यूचर मैं ज्वाइन करना चाहूँगी।
After procuring permission from the Institutional Ethical Committee, we conducted a survey amongst a sample size of 1148, consisting of 150 doctors, 502 medical students and 496 patients. From the survey, we got to know that 90% of the doctors were aware about palliative care. A major chunk of the sample size was of the opinion that palliative care services are not satisfactory at present, with 87% of the doctors were the need of palliative care department in their hospital settings. About 45% of the doctors practicing palliative care also sensitized others through various educational programs. From the survey, we got to know that 71% of the doctors did not know about any training courses in palliative medicine. About 62% of the doctors did not refer patients locations for palliative care services in their respective regions. We also conducted a nationwide online structure survey across 15 Indian states among 502 medical students. And we got to know that an appalling 60% of the medical students were not aware of palliative medicine. Every one out of two students agreed that the introduction of palliative medicine in clinical postings will be a step in the right direction. Out of 52% students who expressed their desire to pursue palliative medicine, a staggering 86% of them did not know about any PG courses. We even conducted a seminar in our college to enlighten the students about palliative medicine. Among the surveyed patients, we got to know that 97% of them were not aware about the concept of palliative care. A major chunk of the patients we surveyed, they chose home-based services over those provided by a hospital setting. Quality of life is a right to all, and to make this a reality, many institutions are providing their services at subsidized rates and at times free of cost. For this, we have conducted interviews of various specialist doctors.
I don't think there would be complementary in any way. There would be basically complementary, because any treating doctor or cancer doctor usually not directly involved with the primary. So where is the question of competition?
I think that would be the greatest thing which can be done in primary care. I think that would be the best thing.
The government has a community. They now they are given a secretary and an employer. They are given themselves.
This is for the medical fraternity, but what about the masses?
NGOs play integral roles in sensitizing the masses. We were fortunate enough to get in contact with Mr. Prakash Gopa from Prithvij
in India. Important for them to create awareness about these issues. And as NGOs play a very important role. We do create awareness in the community. We go talk to them, we organize some awareness campaign.
How do you expect the government to invest in palliative care when our country demands development in so many areas of healthcare, with our diversity being a major burden?
I do not deny the fact that there are various other issues to be focused upon, but we cannot turn a deaf ear to the cries of 5.4 million people who require palliative care annually due to the efforts of eminent personalities. National Program for Palliative Care has finally been included under Mission Flexible by our government. Kerala, Maharashtra and Karnataka have their state policies to overcome the diversity hurdles.
If such government policies exist, why is dispensing, transporting and administering opioids still acrimonious? Why have they been labelled as the villain of the story?
We interviewed two people who played an active role in this area and their views are:
In 2014, it took 19 years of efforts. India simplified the Narcotic Drugs and Psychotropic Substances Act. The central government's law has now changed and many of the licenses have been removed for what the government now calls essential narcotic drugs.
It's not a challenge. So for us, it's game of it for the patients to be raised an animal. Every time the patient takes a capital on it, that is recorded. It's very good that we have really so meticulous in recording every tablet.
Healthcare in India will suffer a major blow if home-based palliative care continues to remain eluded from it. The seed of palliative care has already been sown. Let's water it, nurture it, so that tiny branches of home-based palliative care reach one and all.
Yes, very good. And again, my same thing, like statistics. In all the presentations have not been up to the mark, but the concept and the way you have brought it up is excellent. So good job, guys.
Congratulations to all of you for touching on the topic which is the need of the hour with so much geographic population in our country. Many countries in the Western world do have some system in place, and I think ours being a developing country, the younger generations should volunteer so that the cost for the government is cut down. In fact, it can be made compulsory for all college students to do 1 week, 2 weeks, or 3 weeks of palliative care during their week, so it will spread to more people. Palliative care that is being given back home. We are all from Thane.
We actually got to visit a few homes with the home care teams to see the services that they provide. And we surely have there was a range of services. The quality surely varied, but we found that the services are improving and there are steps. Firstly, there is need for awareness about these services, and accordingly, the quality also has to improve.
My point is, you being undergrads, had you incorporated one slide depicting the kind of services, the scientific modalities that are being administered at home in the form of palliative care, it would have made more impression, presentation-wise.